as wild. Do you know wild? Wild. So my father would come and say, Atiku wafana na! Kuwa ya singa ya kufana na wapala fute ni aritika! Do you understand? You who looks exactly like me, you are the one there doing all sorts of craziness. As to say, if it were somebody that they would not recognize. But you are my cup of coffee. When they find you drunk on the street, say, that is the Herodas. Right there. That is a cup of coffee. Tobu is that. Yeah, yeah. Praise God. What they say, when I see the enemy raining it on you, it's painful for me because I make it my image. And you have chosen to walk away from me. And because you have chosen to walk away from me, because I'm a principle of God, I wait when you return back to me. Did you see that? That at an in time of their trouble, when they cry unto you, you heard from heaven, and according to your abundant mercy, you gave them deliverance to save them from the hand of the enemy. Praise God! Now tomorrow when you come to a funeral, you need to search yourself out. So today we have to search ourselves out before God, for a few minutes. Praise God! Because you don't want to waste your time trying to build something that cannot stand. It is God who has said, you are coming under. Look at the last, give us verse 36, 37, and see what happens. Because of time, I'm not going to read the other part. But I want to show you something. Give us 35. 35. For they have not served you in their kingdom, or in the many good things that you gave them, or in the large, rich land which you set before them. Nor did they turn from their wicked works. You really need to read this scripture. This chapter is so powerful. Praise God. I'm just touching here and there, and it's as if you're not going to get it. But if you read the whole chapter, you understand what I'm talking about. Before this scripture is talking about how he gave them houses that were full of goods and everything that they needed. Praise God. And he said, but even after giving them all that they needed, they did not serve you in their kingdom. Or in the enemy. Or in the many good things that you gave them. Or in the large and rich land which you set before them. Nor did they turn from the wicked works, brother.
Here is where it boils.
Here we are, servants today. Do you see how you are diminished from a sonship to a servant? Here we are, servants today. Listen to this. And the land that you gave to our fathers to eat its fruit and its body. Here we are, servants in it.
You don't have blood flowing through your veins, Elijah, if that does not hurt you.
Can you imagine that the land that was given to you? Praise God. And the man is saying, here we are, we are servants. And the land which you gave to us, it's bounty. To eat its fruit and its bounty. Here we are, servants indeed. This thing belongs to my dad. This thing belongs to me. This is my inheritance. But you know, because I don't have the relationship with the Father, I have been diminished from the sonship. Now I am rest.
Manager, you have walked with you. Do you understand? Read the next one. This is the most painful one. And it does what? And you're not. Now, if you are not mad, if you are not mad about this one, we need to take it to marry someone. No, you have no feelings in you. Because, listen to this. This land is not bad. If it were bad, we are like, who cares? Do you understand? But this land is productive. It yields much increase to the kings that you have set over us because of our sins, and they have dominion over our bodies and our cattle, and they have pleasure, and we are in great. Praise God. When you are going to teach the chimara, the two you want to talk, may you take it at a human. God makes sure it is in. He rubs it so hard in you. Not only are you a slave, but I'm going to show you that what belongs to you actually belongs to somebody else. Somebody is busy eating what belongs to you. Praise God. Now can I touch some few very close battles, and then all of you cast stones on me, and I'm done. And the weekend ends. You are here, you're building a house in Uganda. You don't pay your tithe. When you are finished building the house, you put in a tenant. When you are putting a tenant, they refuse to pay. When you take them to court, they say, this is my house. And then you go. And then you go back, and then you go forth. And then you go back, and then every time you fly, you are spending money. Every time you go to God, they know the God people better than you. This house belongs to who? But because you have refused to pay your tithe, the Bible says, I rebuke the devil on your behalf. God says, I will leave protection over this house. You built it, take care of it. Give us Malachi chapter 3. We are going to stand up and pray. Malachi chapter 3. Please, there are some things that will waste time on. I scatter. I demolish. You demolish. You have never forgiven the sister. When you say, oh, my God, send the fire on the wicked. God is like, no, number one, the wicked is fire.
From this year on.
the heavens.
You are going to work and bring into the pocket with holes.
You are the blood has gone. The...
And God says, listen, God cannot be mocked. Whatever son of man will plant, he will surely reap. You watch them again. You watch him. What are they doing? Praise God. Maybe we need to search back. Praise God. Are the walls standing? Or the walls are already fallen? Praise God.
You wish for others' daughters' marriages to fail. You want your daughter's marriage to stand.
Praise God.
When somebody gets a degree, it's like they stopped you to get a degree. You cannot help, you have sleepless nights, and meanwhile you pray for your children to go to school.
Tell everybody the walls are down.
So,
this is between you and God. Praise God. And the good thing is that Bishop, the Bible says, the young man, Nehemiah, knelt down and reminded God and said, remember what you spoke to your servant Moses, that when we sin against you, you shall cast us to the ends of the earth. What are we doing? Disobedience will cause walls to come down. And the good thing of the story and grace is that each one of us knows the truth. So why don't you take 1 minute right now and empty yourself? Don't scatter when you cannot win. I want to request that you don't move around if it's okay. You don't move around. For 1 minute, search yourself. Maybe the reason things are not happening in your life, maybe there is something that is contrary. Fighting. Maybe the walls have been taken down. There is no more identity. There is no more protection. Search yourself. As I search myself. Praise God. So 1 minute, just search yourself.
We have to be a team. We have to be a team. say, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I come to you with a broken spirit and contrite heart. Say, Lord, shut me out. If there be anything in me that is not of you, take it away. So wash me, purify me from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. Wash me, wash me by the blood of Jesus. That I may be whole before you, Father God, that you may be pleased in my sacrifice before you.
Please go and serve yourself a cup at home. Amen. Before you go to bed.